I'm a ceramist who's studying audiovisual communication. This video is all about making big bowl with local wild clay. So I'm using Kultala clay, which is Finnish red earthenware clay. I hope you enjoy the video. All the wild clays are different, but this clay usually, a lot of people don't use it because it cracks so much. So that's why I'm gonna make sure that the clay goes here in spiral. Then I'm gonna turn it around. I don't know if that's something I thought would help. I'm just gonna turn this around and start all over again. So if you're making a big bowl and don't want to use a lot of power, you can center first one piece and then the second piece. So I'm gonna go. So centering a big piece like this, you need a little bit power, but I'm not doing it with my hands only. I use my whole body, so especially my left leg. So that will give you so much more power. So I wouldn't be able to center this just with my hands. I have a mirror in front of me so I can see the shape all the time. And I'm not pushing to the center, I'm actually pushing forward or to 11 o'clock there. Measure the floor. I have enough clay there. Yes. So working with Kultala clay, it's very important that you go back and forth here in the floor and you make sure that all the clay is also in spiral on the base of the pot, on the floor of the pot. If you're using some other wild clay, and please let me know what kind of problems you have with it. With this clay, the shrinking, it shrinks a lot because there's so much organic matter in it. And the problem with what people usually have is that it cracks really easily. But I'm gonna tell at least tips how I make my big bowls. So when I start lifting, I use the sponge, especially with the big pieces, because it gives me so much more power. And as long as I go height, it's really important to keep this mouth smaller than the base. I had the wheel going a little bit too fast. Right. I like to have quite a lot of clay up here because it looks really beautiful when there's clay on top. It's not too thin on top. This is an 8 kilo piece of clay. So I center first 4 kilos and then 4 kilos. So I have some air bubbles there because I put another part. Where I put another piece, the clay on. So this side, Kultela wild clay pots will take me about half a year to make. So this is not ready yet. After I trim it tomorrow, I will pack it and make sure it's gonna be moist for next at least 4 months, or usually half a year. And first, after several months, I'm gonna start drying them, and that's how I get my pots so that they don't crack. Oops. So I'm learning to talk at the same time when I do work with the wheel. It's a new thing for me. So this time, tomorrow I'm gonna trim this bowl. So now it's really important that the inside shape is finished. I'm missing my favorite tool that's here. Because that I can't change anymore. But the outside gets its shape in trimming. Thank you. this is going to be a spielkum. Spielkum, so I'm making a sprout to it. So white clay shrinks much more than regular clay, so unfortunately you're looking at the really big bowl now, but when it's fired it has so much all kinds of organic matter that will be firing away, so it's going to be much smaller. So if you that was too close there. It's quite wet and rainy, so I'm just going to cover this with a piece of newspaper so that they won't dry too much, and then tomorrow I can trim them and pack them. So here are the tools that I use for trimming. So when I have made this nose, this bottom here is not round anymore. But when you trim, it's really important that it's in the middle up here. You don't have to care so much about this. So don't concentrate on that. Concentrate that this is in the middle and you can check it like this. Okay, I can see that I have to move it this way. Good enough for me. this is my last pod of the year 2020. So I almost made it to 1,000 pots, but this is the last one and it's 968. So that's how many pots, any kind of sculptures I have done this year, 968. This is my mark. So I'm going to show you how I pack my big bowls. So using white clay is truly slow design, so this I'm going to be packed and then I leave them to be. So I want to keep them wet for next. So there they are. I'm gonna leave them there. I call it aging. So I keep the pots moist for at least 4 months. Better to have half an year when you're using local clay, well, the white clay from Kultala, and making big bowls like this. And I will make another video when I finish them and slip decorate them and fire them. And you can see when they are ready next summer.